And of clay are we created by Isabel Allende. And of clay are we created is the last story in the short story collection, The Stories of Eva Luna, which was originally published in Spanish in 1989. The story is about a young girl who gets trapped in a mudslide and a reporter, Rolf Carle, who is sent in a television helicopter to cover her rescue. It is based on the real-life incident involving a 13-year-old girl who was killed in the mudslides caused by melting of sheets of ice as an aftermath of the volcanic eruption in Colombia in 1985. The story unfolds in the first-person point of view of an unnamed narrator, but it can be discerned that Eva Luna, the lover of Rolf Carle and the maker of television documentaries, is the narrator, as she is the narrator of all the other stories in the collection. It is a satire on society, media and politics, which treat human life as a spectacle carrying little value. So when we come to the summary of the story, the volcanic eruption sent an avalanche of mud and snow upon the villages and thousands of men and animals died. The television cameras spotlighted a girl called Azucena holding her head above the mud. The rest of her body was under the mud. Behind her was seen Rolf Carle, the reporter of the television company. He had dared to wade through the clay and threw a tire around her head and tied a rope under her arms. They pulled the rope, but her body remained stuck in the mud. She said that it was not rubbles alone, but the dead bodies of her brother and sisters that entangled her feet. He sought the help of a couple of soldiers, but they had other people to attend. She was not desperate, though almost unable to breathe. He gave her a cup of coffee that gave her a little energy. He sent messages to supply a pump to drain the water under her feet, but was informed that there was no availability or available transport to send it. A military doctor came and examined her and said she would survive the night. Rolf Carle encouraged her by telling stories. A priest passed by and blessed her. More television and movie teams arrived. Azucena's face was beamed to millions of screens around the world. The President of the Republic came and praised her for her courage and promised to speed up the supply of the pumps. Rolf Carle alone was left there to do all that could be done for her rescue. But at last, the girl's head sank and she died. Rolf Carle kissed her forehead and bade her goodbye. He remained in a state of suspensed emotion for several days. And of clay are we created? It's a story that reveals the horror and meaninglessness of human tragedy. It gives us a feeling of deep pity for the girl who dies after terrible suffering and to receive hatred to the official authority who mismanages incidents of disasters. And Rolf Carle imagined himself caught in mire like Azucena. He imagined that he was trapped in the cupboard where his father had locked him for some imaginary misbehavior. Wandering in the midst of memories, he met his sister, Katharina, who kept away from her father, fearing to reveal her retarded body. Brother and sister went hiding under the dining table, where in the end, he found his sister lying dead. All this was the creation of his imagination. And Azucena yielded to death after 3 days and nights of waiting for rescue. But the corrupt officers did not send a pump to drain the water around her. When at last they sent it, she had succumbed to death. Rolf Carle kissed her. After this event, he lost all interest in life. He remained silent in his room, thinking of the tragedy.